Well, if you look at the history of the evolution of the brain itself, you realize that the brain is basically in three parts. The back of the brain is the so-called reptilian brain, the oldest brain, the brain of space, the brain of a reptile that has to locate its prey, its mate, and understand its position in space. That's the back of the brain. As we evolve to the front, we evolve the monkey brain, the brain of society, hierarchy, emotions, the brain that tells you about manners, about etiquettes, how to respect your elders. That's the center part of the brain, the monkey brain. Then the front part of the brain is the most important part for us that distinguishes us from the animals. You see, the animals have a back of the brain, the spatial brain. The animals have a social brain, like wolves. They have a pecking order in the center of the brain. So what do we have? What do we have that the animals don't necessarily have? The front part of the brain governs time. It constantly thinks about the future. It constantly reruns alternate scenarios of what could be the future. Plans, dreams, strategizes. Animals don't do that. When animals hibernate, it's not that they say, oh, I gotta hibernate, time for me to get ready to hibernate. Nope. Animals simply say, instinct tells me, I gotta get ready and I gotta hibernate. So what is it that makes humans different from animals? And what does it, how is it related to success as a human? It's the ability to see the future. To see the future in all its messiness. To be able to recreate scenarios of the future which are realistic. Now, let's go to a psychologist and ask him a simple question. Is there a test that correlates children with success in life? That's a big question. Success in life and childhood. Is there a test that you can perform? It's not perfect, of course, but yeah, there is a test. It's been done around the world. You test kids, and a few decades later, you try to find out if they're successful or not. And you find that, yes, there's one characteristic that does seem to correlate with success in life, lower divorce rate, higher income, higher social status. What is that one characteristic? It's measured by the Marshmallow Test. The Marshmallow Test, you give children the option of eating a marshmallow now or two marshmallows a few hours later. And then you follow these kids for decades in different countries. Now, it's not perfect, of course, but you find that there is a measurable correlation. Now, what's the lesson here? The lesson is the kids which wanted two marshmallows later saw the future. They are the ones who want to plan, the ones who want to go to college, the ones who want to make something of themselves, that hold out. Now, who are the ones who simply get that first marshmallow? It's not perfect, but a lot of them want shortcuts. Shortcuts in life, the easy way out. Now, let's do a science experiment that all of us can perform. If you've graduated from school and you meet your friends years later, like in a reunion, mentally, you sort of ask yourself a simple question. Where are my friends now? After so many years, I haven't seen them. I think maybe they're successful. Or I know this guy. This guy's a loser. He's not going to go anywhere in the world. And you meet them, and yeah, you make some mistakes. But I've found that when I go to my reunions, yeah, the people I thought would be successful became successful. And the ones I thought took shortcuts, yeah, they took shortcuts in life. And so that's why I think the measure of success is seeing the future. That is running simulations of the future over and over again, daydreaming. Should I go to college? Should I get a PhD? Should I become this? Should I do that? Working out all the different scenarios versus the shortcut. I can cut corners. I can steal here. I can fudge this. I can lie about that. That, I think, is a criterion for success in life.